أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وإخوانه وحزبه ومن والاه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، as we proceed through these blessed days of Ramadan, we might feel some difficulties. We might feel some headache, maybe cramping stomach, maybe no sugar, maybe tiredness, long days, sleep deprivation. As we go through these difficulties, we should remember and persevere and remember that the reward of holding patience through these difficulties is limitless. It's beyond any counted limits or numbers or limited numbers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Verily, the perseverance, the patience, get the reward beyond any number limits, beyond any of the numbers written in. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam named this month the month of patience. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, the long hadith about Ramadan, وَهُوَ شَهْرُ الصَّبْرِ وَالصَّبْرُ ثَوَابُهُ الْجَنَّةِ. And it is the month of patience, and patience reward is Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith al-Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُلُّ عَمَلِ بْنِ آدَمَ هُوَ. Every action of a son of Bani Adam is for him or herself. إِلَّا الصَّوْمُ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجِيبَ. It is for me, and I am the one who will reward on it. And the hadith continues, تَرَكَ شَهْوَتَهُ وَمَالَهُ تَرَكَ شَهْوَتَهُ وَطَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ لِأَجْلِي. He or she leaves their desires, their inclinations, their food and their drink for my own sake, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why all actions, different actions, have a set reward. You know, the reward might be multiplied 70 times, 10 times, 700 times and beyond. But fasting is beyond any limits, is beyond any number of limits. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set for himself to set that reward. One of the secrets of why persevering on this month of Ramadan is that a lot of those desires, a lot of those inclinations that we have, if we get enough into it, it overwhelm our lives with excessively, excess of food, of desires, of drink, of sleep, what they end up doing, they end up dulling down or affecting our iman, our spirituality, our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as we limit ourselves, as we contain ourselves, as we cut down on those excess of all those desires, what we do at the end of the day is that we set free our spiritual forces. We unleash our spiritual forces. And that's why you find for yourself in Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a drive to do the deeds beyond other days. So we find it easier to read than just a day. And we find it easier to read Qiyam every night. And we find it easier to step back on those good deeds because our spirituality is high from the fact that we have cut down on our excess of eating, excess of sleeping, excess of indulging in all of those desires. Ibrahim ibn Adham, rahimahullah ta'ala, used to say, said once, ما أرادت أهلك من قبلكم إلا ثلاث إلا حضور الطعام وحضور المنام وحضور الكلام. There is nothing that destroys the people from before you except three, or ruin the life of the people before you except three things: excess or too much eating, too much drinking, and too much sleep. And then Ramadan, we can absorb ourselves into cutting down on all of those things and having some patience to uplift our spirituality by us cutting down those things. It is said from the Qatar that مَنْ تَرَكَ فُضُولَ الطَّعَامِ مُنِحَ لَذَّةَ الْعِبَادِ. Whoever abandons or stays away or cuts down on the excess of eating, but eating too much, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the sweetness of ibadah. We can taste the sweetness of ibadah. ومن ترك فضول الكلام منح الحكمة. And whoever abandons talking and so much indulging in excess of talking unnecessarily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him or her wisdom. ومن ترك فضول النظر منح الخشوع. And whoever abandons the excess of gazing, unnecessary gazing into what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids him to get to that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him or her and the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was an amazing example all year long of this patience, of this exercise, of cutting down on all the excess of life. Sayyidatina Aisha radiallahu anha, in a hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari in his tafsir, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, that Sayyidatina Aisha said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, "Ya Aisha," صام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم طواف ثم صام صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم طواف ثم صام ثم طواف ثم قام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فاسل the whole day and then he kept fasting until the next day and then he fasted the next day and kept fasting until the following day and kept fasting the following day and kept fasting until the following day. That was something special for Rasulullah, something that is forbidden for us, for the Ummah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, but Rasulullah has mentioned in this misal fast consecutive days. And then he said, "Ya Aisha, in the dunya, la tanbaghi li ummat Muhammad wa la li ali Muhammad. Dunya is not suitable for Muhammad or for the family of Muhammad. Ya Aisha, inna Allah lam yarda min uli al-'azmi min ar-rusuli illa bis-sabri 'an makruhiha wa as-sabri 'ala mahbubiha." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept or does not like from the uli al-'azmi, from the messenger, except to stand fast on its hardship, to have patience on its hardship, and to stay, have patience away from its desires. وَلَمْ يَرْضَ مِنْ مُحَمَّدٍ إِلَّا مَا رَضِيَ مِنْ أُولِي الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ فَقَالْ فَاصْبِرْ كَمَا صَبَرَ أُولِي الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ. And he does not accept from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what he commanded the other أُولِي الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ. So he said, have patience as أُولِي الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ had patience. فَوَاللَّهِ لَأَصْبِرَنَّ جُهْدِي وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. But Allah, I will try to have patience as I can, and my ability is only by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another narration, Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha said, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يبتلئ قط شبع. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم never was full out of eating, never ate until he was full. وإني لكنت وربما بكيت بما أرى عليه من أثر الجوع. And it was sometimes in my camp that I would start crying from the excess of hunger that I see on him. وأمسح على رأسه وأقول. And I wipe on his belly and I say, هلا تلقت من الدنيا ما يقويك ويمنعك من الجوع. Why wouldn't you take from this dunya a minimum to nurture yourself and shield you from hunger? And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم has replied, Ya Aisha, inna ikhwani min ulil azmi min ar-rusul. Those messengers from ulil azmi min ar-rusul, sabaru ala ma ashadda min fa'al. This is, have patience from what is harder than this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded me to have patience, as he had patience. أقول قبلي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. Yeah.